Yeah. Click the right thing, you moron. Jeez. That's nice. All right. It's a wet and wacky Wednesday around the Walker house.
I've been up since 4:30, so I am.
How long is the show going to be? This might be the quickest podcast in the history of man for us. Anyway. Yeah, it has been a long day for you. Thank you for taking one for the team. When we had Harper last night, our granddaughter, who is a bundle of joy.
She is. Harper Jane. She says Harper Jane.
Wide open. Wide open.
Yes. Yeah. Well, the excitement was after we picked her up last night.
Because she's been wanting to come to Gingo's house for days.
Yeah. I mean, she woke up yesterday morning ready to go. And we didn't get her till last night.
Yeah.
So she was ready. And we were on our way home with her. And a deer hit our car.
Yeah, this is a case of, and it always happens. What do they say? Things like this usually happen less than 5 miles from home. And sure enough,
less about than 500 feet.
500 feet. Actually, that would be a quarter mile where that, no, 3.35 miles. We know that because it's 0.5 miles to the stop sign from the driveway. It's 0.25 miles up to the Beasley's house where I run when we do our sprint. So it's about 0.35 miles from home. And we come on, and it's foggy as all get out on Tuesday night. And, you know, not a breath of wind. And I saw deer bounding over the field there behind the doxies. I saw his tail. And then the next thing I know, bam! I'm like, oh, you've got to be kidding me. No way.
And Harper's like, what's that? What's that? I said, I think a deer just hit Gingo's car. Mm-hmm. And then she did not stop. So we had to call Caroline. We had to FaceTime her. Reindeer hit Grandma's Gingo's car. Reindeer. That's what she woke up at 4:30 this morning. A reindeer hit Gingo's car.
4:30. She was up till midnight because I was down here working the election coverage.
She was
wide open. But yeah, we had a deer run into the side. And it's not like, you know, you normally think of you hit a deer, you're going to hit it with the front end, it's going to go over the hood, through the windshield, all that stuff. We're going to end up like in Tommy Boy with it in the back seat. No, this was we're going to run into the left front quarter panel right by the door hinge, which already was banged up on excursion to Orlando once.
That was you, not me. But
it wasn't me. I was just cruising along. Some dude decided to make a lane change out of nowhere, and bounced off. Tires bounced off. Didn't really do anything.
Yeah. Well, just needless to say, Sam Walker was in a foul mood last night and this morning.
Because I was already stressed because it was election coverage. Corey Tuck's returns were behind, way behind. So it was not. Yeah. But we all resolved it this morning. Thank you very much, Geico.
Yes.
Not gonna lie.
So the car is going to the dealership tomorrow. Yes. Rental car already arranged. Everything's good.
Everything's good.
And it's deductible is $500, and we could be a lot worse. So.
What is it with our family and things hitting our vehicles? Not us hitting vehicles. I have two stories to go about. This is going to be a long cold open, okay? So my visit to... I'm going to go back 1991. I'm going to go back to 1991. I had done my visit to Campbell to beg and plead to get to get into school with Dr. Jung to be a science teacher. Ha, ha, ha. That changed quick. And on the way back, and we were between, I was driving, I had the Explorer then, the infamous Explorer, and was driving, was between Bethel and Robertsonville on the old US 64, going through the swamp. Everett's is in the little town there in Martin County. Blam! Turn around. What have I hit? You know, I'm a senior in high school. I'm freaked out. You went through that with sliding down the hill and hitting a tree, didn't you? No. What was that? Oh, it was Jen.
Jen
did that. You were with her. Jen did
No,
that.
I wasn't with her.
No, you weren't with her.
She was on her way to pick me up.
Okay. At your house. Yeah. Slid down the hill and... Yeah.
It was raining.
And Dr. Adams said never come back to Klingenberger's house again. No, I'm driving through.
For the record, Mrs. Adams said that.
I thought it was dad. It was the mom. Okay. Stay on target. Where is that? So, yeah, turn around. Actually, it was Bethel. It wasn't Everett's. It was in Bethel. turn around, go back. There is an owl standing on the side of US 64, just standing there, kind of looking at me like, what? What'd I do? And he has flown into the side of the Explorer. Didn't do anything to the truck.
Oh.
Yeah. Let's see. I had a dog at our lab when I was a kid that ran out in the highway when it was still two lanes there in Sligo. Ran into the side of a vehicle. We had a black lab, Susie. Yeah, broke her leg. Ran into the side of it. Caroline, back in 2022. Bear.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, had the bear trying to run. They were coming across through on the shortcut there in the swamp. Yeah. Had that bear run out and hit the side of her Subaru. Front quarter panel, tore it all to hell. So we have this tendency for things to run into our vehicles, not so much us. And then, of course, having a Jeep is the worst thing. When 158 was torn up like it was and falling apart, the best thing that happened for us, for me anyway, I went through two windshields with the Jeep.
Yeah.
Remember when I had the first day I had the blue Jeep?
Mm-hmm.
Driving and forgot how to latch that, you know, brand new Jeep owner, an old Jeep, and forgot to latch the hood fully, and it slammed open on me as I'm going over the Coin Drop Bridge.
Yeah. We've had maybe we just need to get
a bus. We need to walk.
Bikes.
Just run
a bus with a driver.
All right, let's start the show. And welcome to the Sam
and M
podcast, episode 10. Number X. It is, we made it to double digits, amazingly.
Yay.
And they hadn't pulled us off the air yet. Luckily they can. Make sure you like us on your favorite podcast app. Find us on your favorite podcast app. YouTube, Facebook, thanks for watching. Appreciate that. Those of you who like the video element of this show, which I don't know why. Face for radio. We do thank you for liking. It's all you. It's all you. We do thank you for the likes, the follows, the subscriptions, hitting the bell so you know when you get new shows posted, and sharing. Thank you so much to everybody who shared the show on their socials so far. And make sure you do that. Even if you just watch and listen for 5 seconds, just share it, because you never know somebody else who might have nothing to do for an hour a day, a week, and want to waste their time and listen to us. 5 stars. Make sure you're hitting that 5 stars. 5 stars only. It does mean a lot when you do that. Of course, find us at samwalkerobxnews.com. We are, of course, sponsored by great folks at statelinepowerwash.com, Parker and Smith Hammer, serving the Outer Banks in northeastern North Carolina with over 145 star reviews on Google. Schedule now for their March Madness discount.
Oh.
We'll talk about that in just a few minutes, but you can get a great special right now, March through the end of March, when you get signed up with statelinepowerwash.com for their free estimate. Miles Carpet Cleaning, family-owned and operated, offering top-of-the-line carpet and upholstery cleaning services in Currituck and on the Outer Banks with a $99 special. Forget the rest. Call the best right now and like them on Facebook at Miles Carpet Cleaning. And Harlow Photography, your local natural light expert, capturing the beauty of the Outer Banks, online at sharlowphotography.com. It is the Sam and Elm podcast, and we got shout-outs. Do we need a theme for shout-outs, or do we just...
No, we do not need a theme.
We need a theme for everything. I want to play music under everything. So anyway, go ahead. There.
So Sam will be running the 10K... next month at Disney Springtime Surprise in a tutu.
Yes, I will be doing it.
Yes, thank you, Donna Walton. Sam will be wearing a tutu. He will be acting silly. For some reason in my head, I'm seeing Jim Carrey. Jim Carrey-esque.
Yeah, there you go. All right, we'll do the dance.
So anyway, she did send me a message. She said, I don't know Sam, but I have no doubt that he will live this one up. So thank you, Donna. Kelsey's Hope appreciates it. We are now at...
And she made a $250 donation.
Yep.
So the deal is, so the 10K is covered.
Yes, we do have two more races.
5K
if
and a 10-mile. If you want to give $250, I will wear a tutu in the 5K. $250, I'll wear a tutu in the 10-miler.
Yes.
And if you do that, if we get two more 250s, that puts us over our fundraising goal. at Kelsey's Hope.
Puts
Kelsey's
us right
Hope Foundation.
At it. Puts us right.
Puts
at
right.
At
it. Would, it,
put
yeah.
us, it would be $74.
It puts us right at it.
I also want to give a shout out though to Sylvia. Sylvia, my friend Sylvia, who went with us mm-hmm. on our trip.
Yep.
She has given a donation. Lee Niemeyer, second shout out, girl. Thank you. She gave it. Teresa Young. She came. It's really crazy. I met her for the first time at a. She came here for the Kelsey's Hope resin party.
Yes.
Her daughter, I think, worked with you as an intern or something with the. Wasn't her daughter?
I believe that's right.
Three?
It was
yeah.
an intern. Yeah. Teresa, remind us how that happened. But yeah, Teresa lives down in Grandy.
Yeah.
And then she came and now, yeah.
And now she's.
Likes everything, and follows, to share. She does what we ask you to do, which yeah. is like, follow, share. Yeah.
And she has actually reached out to me about. Hosting a resin party for Kelsey's Hope down at her
Carolina
down there.
Club.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So thank you, Teresa. And Caroline Fernandez, as you are in my phone, Caroline from the Lululemon store
in Williamsburg.
Again, just a neat, cool person that I met along the way that we now meet up at different races. Mm-hmm. And she's just an amazing person, but she also gave a donation. So we've got a bunch of shout outs that will be coming yeah. along at the different mile markers. So y'all be ready, but there's still $10 a mile marker. And lots of people have given more than $10, and that means you get more than one mile marker.
Yep.
So anyway, there's that, and the link is
links in the descriptions.
Links
so
in
just look in the description on the videos and on the podcast, you know, on your platform. Yep. Just look in the description. You'll find the link to give, and you'll find a link to find out more about Kelsey's Hope, which Emily just finished that run 2 weekends ago yep. for the Disney Princess Half Marathon. It's been doing this for the last 7 years mm-hmm. for Kelsey's Hope. It is such a cool charity. If you haven't gone back and watched last week's episode or the week before where we really get into what Kelsey's Hope is all about, you can do that. It's a good way to promote the previous shows. But a $10 donation will get you a shout out at the mile marker of your choice during whatever race you want. So 5K, 10K, and 10 mile. We're going to do yep. it. We're going to record them, video, and post them on our socials. We'll probably run that as a Sam and M podcast on the road.
But each day after the race,
we'll do a full shout out video yeah. after we each race that day, which means we won't be spending that much time in the parks, which means we won't be spending that much money. So we'll sit by the pool and do video editing.
And Gail, Kelsey's mom, reached out to me.
Gail Marshbanks.
Yeah. And yep. she said she listened last week and she loved
cool.
it and was just, she's very appreciative. And so anyway, hello, Gail. And anyway, I hope we get a couple more shout outs, or I'd love to see you running in a 2-2 all three races.
Yeah.
So anyway, those are my shout outs.
We you know what? We'll have to talk more about it because we got to get into costume. We'll do that later because we've got to figure out now with the 2-2 working into our costume themes because there's a whole we do costumes based on the theme of the race or the weekend or. You know, whatever. We'll do a whole segment about that coming up here because it's 6 weeks from now, you know?
I know. We're down there
in 6 weeks to run. Shout outs that I've gotten. Thanks, everybody who came out to the night with the candidates down at Sanctuary Vineyards last week. That was a literally last minute thing that John Wright's idea down at Sanctuary Vineyards threw that together for us. He came up with the idea, along with his dad, Tommy, and his uncle, Jerry, of having the candidates in a different forum. This was the county commissioner candidates and Corey Tuck and the registered deeds candidates that were on the ballot for the Tuesday election, or the primary. And we threw that together. The candidates all came out. We had one whose fiance was close to going into labor, so he wasn't able to be there. But everybody that came had a great time. You know, one of those things, I've done these forums before, and it's a casual. I don't like the stand. I've done those before and not really a fan of them, where you stand up behind the podium and everybody has 2 minutes. Ding. You know, all that stuff that you've seen on TV forever. Make it a little different. Everybody relax. That was the fourth forum they'd done that week. It was the last one before the primary. Everybody is really burned out from the campaign. Totally get it, especially in a county like Currituck. And you got someone who lives in Corova that's running, someone who lives in Knott's Island, and then the 40 miles of the mainland. So thanks to everyone who came out. And thank you, everybody who gave us shout-outs, threw us questions online. It was really a cool event because it was even more different than I'd done before, because everyone that I'd done before was Dare County. And this being Currituck is just a little bit more intimate knowledge. friendships with the candidates, or et cetera, et cetera. People that were everyone that came and saw. But thanks everyone who's given us all the great compliments they gave us online. A lot of them giving them to us because of their work situation and having to be careful about that. But thanks to everyone who gave us the shout outs and the great compliments we got that night. There's talk about maybe doing this on a regular basis with the Board of Commissioners in a town hall setting, and or do a town hall in a similar setting. But thanks to John Wright for that great idea. And it's always cool. We've been had a chance to hang out there a lot, drinking a lot of wine. The Morton. I should have brought the bottle of Morton here. I like the Morton. That's a
well,
good
one.
Well,
we have one. A bottle in there.
We got the bottle in there I got from the run. So, yeah. So, anyway, if you've got a shout-out, something you want to reach out to us, compliments, comments, questions, things you want us to talk about, make sure you hit us up on our socials. All you got to do, tag us on the Facebook page, send us a message, send us an email, you know, do that. And we'll talk about it here on the show because there's going to be times when it's like, holy cow, what the hell are we going to talk about?
Like today.
Today.
I'm not going to lie. I am just exhausted. Like, I just don't think I've had a chance to, like, catch up from the travel.
Yeah.
I had one day off, and I've been working, and then
yeah,
Harper didn't sleep last night. Yeah. Or I just am exhausted. Like, I was going to clean today. I was going to do all kinds of stuff, and I just – well, the rain didn't help either, and –
yeah.
Anyway, so
the rain didn't help. Man, it has fallen a flood for these last 3 days. Holy cow.
So be warned. Saturday is deep
is work
day.
Okay. All right. So. One more shout out. We're going to make sure Justin at the Outer Banks This Week podcast. We're going to be on there in 2 weeks. This week's guest, somebody we've had on our first Sam and M on the road, Gino Say at Lost Colony Tavern. They're going to be talking about all the stuff they got coming up next weekend for St. Patrick's weekend. They got a lot of cool stuff that's set up for that in downtown Manio. So make sure you check that out on your favorite podcast platforms and OuterBanksThisWeek.com. Of course, you can find Captain Marty there now with his daily fishing reports, which is really cool. You know, you can download them and listen to them on demand, which I love having that ability to be able to listen to them anytime I want. And, you know, so there's our shout outs here on the Sam and M podcast. So that gives us an opportunity to do a couple of clicks and pull down screens and do all this stuff because we do have things we have to do. And, oh, I did not change that graphic. I'm sorry, guys. They sent me a new graphic and I didn't change it. So we're going to use this one more time. But it is the Sam and M podcast, and it is sponsored by StatelinePowerWash.com. Pressure washing, soft washing, painting, concrete floor sealing, but they now do more than just that. StatelinePowerWash.com, locally owned and operated by Parker and Smith Hammer. They grew up right here in Currituck with a local staff, so you know that you're keeping it local with Stateline Power Wash. And get in on their March Madness special. Are we allowed to say that? Who cares? Get a free gutter cleaning when you get your house and roof soft wash. That's right. Free gutter cleaning. Get your house and roof soft wash. They'll do the gutter cleaning all for free, but only in the month of March. So call them now. Email them now. Whatever. Hit them up. StatelinePowerWash.com. Don't forget also Smith Hammers with Kingdom Real Estate Services so you can buy or sell a home or land. You list your home with Smith and he'll free house wash and roof wash and deck clean up all that. As well, check out the Moyoc Real Estate Market Facebook group. It's the spot to be for local Moyoc real estate. Ready to freshen up the outside or inside of your home? Then Stateline Power Wash will get you covered with their painting and staining services that'll brighten the look of your primary home, the home that's going on the market, or your vacation rental. Over 140 five-star reviews, actually over 150 now. We can update the copy. On Google, you know whatever you have Stateline Power Wash do for you, it's going to be top-notch. From Moyoc to Manio, Edenton to Duck. I saw one of their signs in Manio today. Schedule now with Stateline Power Wash at StatelinePowerWash.com. Get a free gutter cleaning when you have your house and roof soft wash, but you got to do it now before the end of March. StatelinePowerWash.com or call 252-421-3775 for your free estimate.
I think I saw today on Facebook they were power washing today. In
this
rain.
Monday they were out there doing it in the rain.
You guys are the MVP. I know, but
you're already wet. Why not? but yes.
I was like, that just makes me even more impressed with you, young men.
Yeah. Shout out to you guys. Shout out to you guys for the for working in the rain.
So yes.
We all get to do that. Okay. We, of course, are getting ready for, and not too long, two Saturdays. One Saturday, 1 week away. It's, you know, this show drops this week, and it's one Saturday away, March 16th.
Yep.
It is the 5th annual Moyock Women's Club Whiteout for Hunger Charity Gala, Loblolly Estate in Jarvisburg. Tickets still available, or is that, I know we had to get tickets in last week.
I know we had to get tickets and money in, but if someone wants to go, reach out to me, and I'm sure we can make it happen.
Yep, we can do that. Well, we're getting ready for the whiteout party. And I'm at, down there covering this legislative commission meeting, and I get a notification on the phone, Amazon delivery, and I'm like, "Oh, and it's pouring rain." I was like, "Em, get the packages that are on the porch now, because there's outfits in there." Now, you have gone and done outfits. And, well, let's talk about that, because, I mean, that's what it's all about. I mean, you don't have to show up in white, all white, but it's the theme, and it is kind of fun. And you've done this several times where you've gotten specific outfits.
Yeah. No, it's fun. But I was thinking, like, so this year
for you,
I just...
Let's talk about you first, and we'll get to me. Yeah.
Stop cutting me off.
Okay. I didn't know where you were going, but I want to make sure it's kind of leading you.
I mean, every year it's kind of going out and finding an outfit. I've worn like pantsuits, I've worn dresses, I've done stuff. And the other night I was like, scrolling. And you were like, are you not, like, can we not go to sleep or whatever? And I was like, I have to find a dress. And you fell asleep, and I ordered, I think, two dresses off of Amazon the next morning. You're like, I see you found a few things.
Yeah.
But, so they came Monday, and I tried them on, and one we sent back yesterday, and you said we already got the credit for
We got the credit while we were here getting ready for the show.
So, so I just got a simple dress off of Amazon, nothing fancy. But the spray tans are the late Andy Kramer's coming, and next Friday, and there are four or five of us getting tanned up and ready. The tan looks good against the white.
All right, give her the right shout out now. What's the name for
Island Spray Tan?
Island Spray Tan. Andy That's Kramer. The official spray tan of the Sam and M podcast. Angie has done so much business in our main room here. It's not funny.
She really is cool. She comes in and she's fun. And anyway, I'm just wearing a simple white dress, and I just thought you might be wearing like khakis and a white shirt and a tie, but evidently.
But see, I've done that before. I have. So I was khakis and a white shirt and a tie. Okay, so it had this one thing about the weight loss. Has been the fact that I have a closet full of clothes I can't wear anymore. And you've dealt with this, as we have a fly buzzing around. So if you notice it's swatting and looking around, we got invaded. I'll stay on target. Stay on target.
We're too close. Stay on target.
Yeah. It's having a closet full of clothes that you can't wear anymore. And it's been difficult to get rid of those because, one, most of the stuff that I wear and I have, I consider unique, because I've always been one that shies away from the regular plain polo and things. I want T-shirts that either are Disney themed specifically to the parks, or locally Outer Banks themed, or whatever, whether it's, you know, a marina or tackle shops, or, you know, just the stuff that I have. Well, it's all double XL and larger. Well, let's go into the dress shirts and the suit jackets and sport coats that I have, which I rarely ever wear. And they're all four sizes now too big. You have gone through that for the last 8 years of that incredible shrinking woman. And meaning everything in your closet doesn't fit anymore. I have gone through that over the last year. And as difficult as it's been to get rid of a lot of things, at the same time, it's been kind of satisfying to go and I don't ever remember wearing this. I'm wearing a shirt right now. It's a large. Mm-hmm. I don't ever remember
wearing
large. Going from a 36 almost to a 38 down to a 31. Mm-hmm. I'm wearing 31 pants right now. And wouldn't even know it and actually fit. Now, I, for some reason, I've gone from 30 length to 29. I don't understand. I'm shrinking. But I think some of that might have to do with the fact the way I wear, because I wear pants low hip. And just how things are being cut. They're just, I don't know. There's something about the cut on them. So.
Cary Dover and Jeff Dover, here we go. He's talking about the cut.
The European size extra large. Yeah, European extra large is actually an American large, which I can wear now. Thank you very much.
We were at Disney
Pair shirt.
Carrie's a really good friend of mine, yeah. And I haven't told her. I was like, Sam is cracking me up. He's like, your polo shirt, your button down Ralph Lauren shirt or whatever that you wear to church and weddings. You were like one morning like, this doesn't fit. It's not the same size. It's a European cut because you had gained weight, but right. You weren't going to admit it. And she's like, no, he's not. So then we were at a wedding, the four of us talking, and Sam's like, yeah, and my shirt's not fitting because of that European cut. And Carrie's like, oh, you were serious.
Yeah,
I was like, yeah, Sam's blaming the European cut.
We had the Euro step in basketball. We had the Euro cut in clothes. But no, it's because I was getting fatter. I was getting larger. So now I'm in a situation where I do not have a dress, a jacket that I could wear. I do not have one because it's not, which is weird because you would think, okay, chest, shoulder, you know, that's going to be, you know, you can button it now. It's too long. I don't get it. I don't remember.
It just sags.
Well, it's too long. So I don't have anything. So I was like, all right. So over the weekend, I'm working a gymnastics meet up in Virginia Beach. And I've got time between sessions. And I was like, you know what? Let's get tropical. Okay. Not tropical in terms of look, but I was trying to, you know, let's get a little weird. Let's, you know, I've got this thing now. I'm wearing a tutu to run at Disney. I am known for the shirts that I have now. You know, everybody sees me out and about. And they're like, why are you wearing something plain? That's odd. You know, if I'm not wearing the short sleeve park candy shirts that, you know, they're wild. I mean, that's my gimmick now, I guess. So I decided, what the heck? So I get on Amazon and I found a white suit. I've got the whole thing. I got the shoes still to come. Now, I'm not doing the white shoes. I thought about that. And then now I have rethought the look because I couldn't find just a white jacket, the white dinner jacket. I wanted to go with the Sean Connery white dinner jacket, black tie in Diamonds Are Forever. Okay, that's the look I'm going for. But he wears black pants.
I would prefer the black pants versus white
pants. Okay, all right. Well, that's what we got. So we've got this suit upstairs. It came from Amazon. But the cool thing about it was it's on Amazon, and you have not been able to figure out this.
I didn't know it existed. I didn't know it existed.
So I've got this suit that I'm going to try on after the show, figure out if it fits. If it doesn't fit, guess what? I send it back. I can send it back in 7 days, and you don't get charged for it either. It's not like they charge you up front and then refund you. Like, you know, Amazon's really cool, like we said, with the refunds. This is a situation. I haven't paid a dime for it. If I don't like it, it doesn't fit. Because the sizes didn't look quite, I couldn't get any to match, you know, it was like, oh, I need this width of jacket, but I need this length of pants and this width of pants, whatever. I get to send it back, so we're going to find out. But I went with the white jacket, the white vest, the white pants. I don't think the white pants are going to happen. And if I keep it,
in my head, it's just all I can think of is Dumb and Dumber. Like, I just keep thinking of that orange suit and that blue suit.
I could have gone there, and I did. I did look, and I almost bought, and I may still buy it just to get it. I found a lime green suit.
Oh, my.
Lime green suit with tie.
Oh, my.
I almost went with that to wear. And then I was like, no, I want the white dinner jacket. I want to go with that look. I've always wanted to pull that off. I can't remember.
Now, look, I love you.
Because I was too fat to do it.
But you haven't necessarily pulled it off yet.
No, because I haven't tried it yet. But I feel like now I can because I do feel more. And it's not so much that it looks better, maybe on the outside. But to me, I feel like I can pull it off.
I'm just teasing. I'm very proud of you, and I'm glad that you feel no matter what you wear, I want you to know, I want you to feel comfortable.
But
I may be sitting on the other side of the room.
Now, I didn't go with the ruffled shirt.
Thank you.
I didn't go with the ruffled shirt.
Did you go with, like, Colin Ennis shoes or Eddie Ennis shoes? You know how they always get real fancy, like they always
have
their shoes.
No, I got the black patent leather.
Oh, you didn't get, like, they'd wear a white suit. Maybe you should have talked to Colin. He could have helped you get a white suit.
That's what I mean.
Gold and white. The Ennis boys always have the top of the line, but they always have the shoes that match them too.
Right. See,
I was like, oh my gosh.
I did look at
James
that.
Sue, he likes them.
Yeah, I know. I looked at the white. I looked at trying to go with maybe pulling the full on total 100% white. Look, I don't think I could do that.
I think Ian is doing the white. Or they had talked about for the wedding doing white.
White.
Yeah.
Okay, so I could pull it. So maybe I can wear this again.
No.
All right. Well, we haven't even taken it out. It's still upstairs in the packaging.
Look,
I am so
negative. I'm like, no. I haven't even seen it yet.
You haven't
even
seen it yet.
I mean, Sam, I come down with my dress. He's like, oh, that looks good. I'm like, I don't know.
Yeah, she goes the whole thing, and I'm like, no, it looks awesome.
And mine's just a little sweater dress. So anyway.
Well, but this goes back to the whole weight loss journey. Because before, I would have been sitting there thinking, I hate wearing tucked shirts because of my gut, flat out. Yesterday when we went to the thing down at Trio, and we're going to talk about that in the next segment. We bought this Gap large button-down gray shirt, and I'm like, it actually looks good untucked. I wasn't comfortable with wearing it. It just felt uncomfortable because I was going to wear a quarter zip over it, and I just need to tuck the shirt tail in. And in the past, I would have been dreading that because the shirt tail would never stay tucked in and all. Now, it's not something I even think about twice about.
Right.
You know, I mean, as I've talked about it before on the show about, you know, how I feel better, I feel like I look better now in the lacrosse field because I don't have that gut sticking out and my shirt tail not wanting to stay in and the baggier shorts and all that. Now everything is much, I feel more comfortable wearing form fitting. And you've gone through that with being more comfortable. I mean, even with wearing more form fitting clothing in general, and you still say, oh, that's too tight. It's too tight. I was like, no, it looks great because it fits. It looks good because it fits. But, like, even what you wore in the 10K at Disney, you would have never worn that, would you?
Mm-hmm.
That costume, which we showed on the show last week. I don't know if I still got that picture up or not.
It's all right. You don't have to put it back up there, honey.
I want to because it's such a great picture. No, it's not that one. Where is it? I know it's still here.
No,
I don't have it up there, so.
Yeah, I mean.
But, I mean, the crop top. You would not have worn the sports bra and you would not have worn that.
No, probably not.
Even a year ago when you started.
I mean, I still didn't feel confident wearing it, though, just for the record. Okay, like, well, I didn't feel confident wearing it, but I was hot as Hades, and I had to take the undershirt off. So,
right.
I mean, I felt more confident, but, I mean, I think you're always going to be, if you talk about clothing and yes, I definitely wear things that fit now that I don't wear over baggy, and I definitely wear a belt now. I've got belts I never wore, I haven't worn a belt in forever. But there's still always in your head the things you heard through the years. I mean, when you were, I was not joking, I was born a butterball. So my weight has always been an issue. So those things come in my head. The stripes, don't wear stripes. Vertical stripes, don't do.
Yeah.
I mean, those things still come in my head,
right.
You know. But, it is a lot more fun and getting smaller sizes. And
it's a heck of a lot easier shopping.
Yeah, I mean. Sam and I, like, for date night, sometimes we'll just go to the Goodwill store.
Yeah, because, one, you find some pretty good deals on some pretty good shirt I'm wearing right now. It's a Vineyard Vine founded at the Goodwill in Southern Shores. Don't go there looking for that stuff, folks, because I want it first.
For $4.25.
For $4.25.
Anyway,
I mean, come on.
Anyway, so we're getting ready for this whiteout party and trying to.
You know, I was going to try and pull off the surprise. That you would have had no idea that I had done this.
Till that day.
The only reason one, the weather, because the package, and two, I do want to see, because I've got a feeling the pants are going to have to be hemmed. I don't know why, but when the labeling, the sizes, like the waist size for a 31 waist, but the length was like 38. But I don't think that matters. It just didn't make sense. So I'm sitting here thinking, okay, I wonder if they send them unhemmed, which is fine. Annette Samborski, I'm going to be coming to your house. I already got you to sew those patches on my officiating shirts. Now I'm going to have to come to get some pants hemmed.
Amazing.
So we'll see. We're going to try this. I don't know if I'm going to try. Are you cold?
I am cold. All of a
it has been weird. It's just wind and it's weather. It's weird to have that. You're saying it's cold and we got invaded by fuzzy bills last night. Holy cow. Speaking of power washing, that's something that the State Line Power Wash will do. Get those fuzzy bills off the house. They've been stuck on there all winter. Yeah, the fuzzy bills are back. The wind died out last night. We got sucked a whole bunch of them. Are they still? I see one over there on the ceiling. Yeah, they're still here. I hate those things. All right. So, hey, we made it through one segment talking about clothes. All right. What are we going to talk about now? We are going to talk about our good friends at Miles Carpet Cleaning. As winter doldrums are finally going away, almost. Have they got you tired of looking at those dingy carpets or furniture? All this rain, you've tracked all the mud in, the dogs brought in the mud, and your carpets all of a sudden look like crap? Well, you know, hey, it's never too early for spring cleaning. Miles Carpet Cleaning, they'll get those carpets, those rugs, that upholstery, even those vehicle interiors looking and smelling like new. Serving Currituck and the Outer Banks, Miles Carpet Cleaning family has been cleaning things up on both sides of the water for the last 8 years. Their $99 special can't be beat. Three rooms and a hallway clean to perfection, including orange scent carpet deodorizer and Scotch Guard for just $99 from Miles Carpet Cleaning. Book it now before the spring rush begins, 252-207-6707, and find more great offers by following Miles Carpet Cleaning on Facebook. Robert Miles and his family will take care of you like you're one of the family. Make sure you tell them you heard about it on the Sam and M podcast. I know they've had several folks have done that. Thank y'all for doing that. That really means a lot when you do that. Forget the rest. Call the best. Miles Carpet Cleaning at 252-207-6707. That's 252-206-707. The Sam and M podcast also brought to you by CMIT. When it comes to managing your business, it's important to have the right technology. That's why CMIT works to help businesses. Short for Completely Managed Information Technology, CMIT offers everything a business needs. Their services include tech support, computer and server security, cloud backup, secure Wi-Fi, business phones, and more. I'll tell you one thing. With all the internet issues everybody's been having around here all winter, on the beach especially, that CMIT offers this really cool thing where they will put in an automatic switcher that'll switch you from, say, your fiber connection. They'll switch you to cellular. So you will get cellular data as your backup. So if your internet goes out at your business or your home, but at your business, and it takes out the phones because you've gone with the phone, you know, with that type of phone system, you can't process credit cards, this will automatically switch over to a wireless cellular carrier as your backup data connection. And then once the fiber or whatever your internet service comes back, it slips right back over. You don't have to do anything. It does it all itself with smart technology through CMIT. CMIT will help get your technology and it'll keep stay up and running. For more information, go to CMITOBX.com. Scott DeMasi, thank you so much for jumping on board at SamWalkerOBXNews.com and being a part of the Sam and M podcast. I love a listicle. I love a listicle. You know what a listicle is?
No idea.
A listicle is top 10 things, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Easy to write, easy to copy, and they generate a lot of chatter on socials because, you know, everybody debates what a top 10 list should be or whatever. You know, we make a lot of top lists. Dr. Beach has ranked our beaches, you know, Ocracoke twice has been the number one beach on Dr. Beach's list. Dr. Stephen Leatherman from down in Florida International. Yeah, he's at Florida International. Yeah, he's at FIU. There's all these different lists. I love them. They're easy to write. And again, they generate content generation that gets a lot of interaction. Okay, so our colleagues at Axios Raleigh, back on Friday in their daily morning newsletter, which is one of the newsletters, many newsletters that I've subscribed to. That's how I start my day. Is reading all these email newsletters. Axios, I've got the NC Tribune, I've got Axios Richmond now. I follow theirs because I'll find some cool little nuggets that we can use. Cool little nuggets for us when we go back to Richmond or if we ever get back to Raleigh. We don't seem to get to Raleigh that much. Anyway, so they put out a, and everybody's going to be doing this, a March Madness bracket. I have thought about doing a March Madness bracket contest. This year, I don't think I'm going to do it. I think next year. Mainly because I want to see something happen this year that if I have a bracket, I'm going to jinx it. I would like for it to happen very much so. But anyway. So they put out to their Axios readers a bracket on Friday. North Carolina's best beach, according to Axios readers. Now, this is Axios Raleigh doing this.
So let me guess, it was all like southern beaches.
Oh, Wilmington. Well, let's get into how the first round was done. So I like ripped them on all the socials, and I've gotten some blowback on it now from the Raleigh folks after I posted today because of who made the finals. So they had in the first round, Bald Head Island versus Carolina Beach, Cure Beach. So you basically got an exclusive island you can only get to by ferry on the Sound, the Cape Fear coast, against their neighbors across to the north, immediately to the north. Makes no sense. They also had Corolla and Corova versus Duck. How do you put teams in the in the same conference in the first round, North Carolina High School Athletic Association, who used to do that to us all the time? How do you do that?
So you immediately take out your...
You're taking out half of the field from the same part of this coast. It makes no sense. I can see...
If you did Corolla versus Hatteras.
Baldhead Island and Corolla should be number one seeds. Sorry. Mm-hmm. Well, Ocracoke should actually be the number one overall seed. Because it's been number one by everybody. Mm-hmm. So they had that matchup. They had Reitzel Beach against Topsail. No.
That's not even like a fair fight.
Talk about, and that's not, that really isn't. It's not.
I mean, I'm not trying to be ugly, but it's not a fair fight.
Yeah. You want to get as far away from that microphone as you can?
I do. My back is hurting. Okay. I'm just a baby tonight.
Slide the magma. You want to hold it?
No, I'm just being a baby.
Hold the mic. Seriously. It will be easier.
I don't want to.
Okay. All right. This one really pissed me off. Sorry. Hatteras Island. They just looped the whole island together. Two completely different beaches, if you think about it.
Yeah.
Against Ocracoke. No. No. If you're going to, and I did, I got to go back. I have to go back and find how I think I paired off like how it, you would put two totally divergent beaches against each other in the first round. At least make it fair. Mm-hmm. But Hatteras, you're going to put Rodanthe Wave Salvo and Avon and Buxton, which really, if you think about it, the RWS beaches, P Island is its own naked
black
sand.
The black flies are, I hate the black flies
on
P Island.
Okay, yes, that is one bad thing about it. But the naked, P Island, you're going to group P Island, Rodanthe Wave Salvo, which has its own unique characteristics, Avon, which has its own uniqueness, Buxton, which has its own uniqueness, with Frisco and Hatteras, which south-facing beaches, so it's a totally, so if the wind's blowing out of the southwest, you got waves down there, and it's, you know, Lake Atlantic on the east side. Right. Against Ocracoke, which is consistently ranked as the number one beach in the country, over Waikiki,
right?
Over all the beaches of Florida and California and everywhere.
Well, I didn't understand what you were talking about when I saw your post, and I didn't.
That's it.
I ask you, but now I get it, and I think that's a fair assessment. So, what was the blowback today?
All right, well, we'll get to that because I want to get through the rest of the first round matchup because they don't make sense. Cape Lookout, which is as isolated as you can get, again versus Emerald Isle. Totally, not even close. How many people have actually been to Cape Lookout? Because you have to take a ferry or a boat to get there, and it's not as easy a way. It's not like jumping on the ferry. As difficult as getting to Ocracoke is, as difficult as getting to Baldhead Island is, they did leave Figure Eight Island out at least, which is, you know, gated community. You can't get in there. You have to have multiple commas, but up front in front of the decimal point to get into Figure Eight. Holden Beach against Ocean Isle. No. Again, why are you putting teams in the same conference together? Then they had this one does actually. I was satisfied with how this one turned out. Nags Head, Kitty Hawk, Kill Double Hills against Atlantic Beach.
So now, they put the three beaches against
one. Well, they put the whole North Beach because Duck and Corolla. How does it Duck and Corolla get broken out? But then yeah, they didn't include Southern Shores, by the way. They left them out totally. I mean, come on. How do you kick out? How do you do that? You group the three North Beach towns, which do have their own different character with it. The beach. I mean,
are they comparing the beach or are they comparing the town?
You know what? It just says best beach. There. I don't know, but they weren't very precise about it. Very specific. And then the final matchup was Oak Island versus Sunset Beach. So Kitty Hawk, Kittle Hills, Nags Head beat Atlantic Beach with 64%. Duck beat Corral and Corova with 56%. And Ocracoke beat Hatteras with 59%. Second round, Wrightsville Beach beats Ocracoke. Not a fair fight.
Well, it's too if it's the beach part versus that, like, this is what I'm curious about because I'll be honest. I love both places.
Yeah.
But Ocracoke, you're going to go. There's a few restaurants. It's more of really just you're going to the beach, you're riding your bikes, whatever.
Yeah.
Wrightsville Beach, there's a lot more. There's beach and a lot more restaurants, a lot more
party. Yeah, it's a different atmosphere. Yeah, it's a different atmosphere. So Wrightsville Beach beats Ocracoke with 61%. Baldhead beat Duck, 61%. See, I wouldn't even. Baldhead to me shouldn't have been included. I don't know. Well, I say they should have been included, but at least you can get there. The public has access. Second round was Nags Head, Kitty Hawk, Kittable Hills against Oak Island, so that's Caswell and Oak Island and all the little that whole stretch there. They combined it into one town many years ago. By 51-49, that was a close one. But yeah, I mean, okay, they're somewhat similar. They are kind of similar. Oak Island, I don't know. I mean, I guess so. Oak Island actually feels more like as you get farther north, it actually feels more like Duck as you head up to Caswell. But yeah, so I can see that. Then in the final four was Emerald Isle against Nags Head, Kitty Hawk, Kittable Hills. Emerald Isle won because Raleigh. Wrightsville Beach beat Bald Head Island. So it's Wrightsville Beach and Emerald Isle in the final. And as of this taping, Wrightsville Beach was winning 54-46 over Emerald Isle. So now, Wrightsville Beach, we hung out. Yeah, I can see the Raleighites, you know.
Well, we've been to both. We've hung out at both.
Yeah. Would you prefer Wrightsville Beach over Emerald Isle?
Again, my experience at Emerald Isle is more beach. We were staying at Rita's family's house. So, I mean, right on the beach. And so we didn't. So to me, my atmosphere, if I want to go to a beach and just do the beach,
yeah,
I would pick Emerald Isle. If I wanted to go somewhere where during the day I'm doing the beach, but then I want some atmosphere, some good restaurants, some other stuff to do, I would have picked Wrightsville Beach.
You want to Trolley Stop hot dog?
Yeah.
Well, that's like, Wrightsville Beach.
Yeah. I mean, we do have John's, though, so, you know.
That's right. We do have John's. Yes.
So,
Spankies. We have Spankies.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You know, so, I mean, I guess it's just what the kind of mood you're in for. So, you know, I mean, they're all kind of different.
Well, I'm just going to say it. That it's my whole everything east of I-95 doesn't exist when it comes to Raleigh. If you ask someone from Raleigh... If you had asked someone from Raleigh 30 years ago if they'd ever been to the Outer Banks, 95% of the people wouldn't even know what you're talking about. Now, since then, half of Ohio and Pennsylvania have moved to Raleigh. This is where they all came, and this is where they come. But still, there's still the Northeast the bias against the Northeast. That's what it is.
But what that does is it just keeps our gem a little bit more of a gem.
That's true.
It just keeps.
That's true. That's true. That's true. But it is a little frustrating to see our own state.
But you know, we've never done Baldhead Island. I'd like to go. I've never been there.
We have not been Baldhead. Seen it.
I would like to go.
Yeah. Well, of course, that's where you know we have seen it. We've seen it in the movies. Weekend at Bernie's was filmed there. In case you didn't know.
Who was it in college? That was a.
She was dating my roommate. Yeah, she was an extra in a restaurant scene that was shot at Roy's Riverboat Landing, what used to be called Roy's in downtown Wilmington.
Yeah, is it not called Roy's anymore?
No, it, I know, remember, it's an Italian restaurant. No, they took Roy's off of, yeah, down there. Yeah, so anyway, so yeah, Axios.com, search Raleigh. If you go on my socials, you'll see it. I did, yeah, let me see if I've got somebody. One, my buddy Hayes Permar, who runs, who bought the Rialto Theater up there in Five Points in Raleigh.
Oh.
He commented on it. There's some. One thing about my socials, I will admit, my socials really, my socials really do get hammered with all the stuff I post. Probably too much content. Okay.
Not you.
Not me. Yeah. Okay. Here it is. All right. Well, let me give you some of the comments that have been on the Facebook. What did he say? Man, there's a lot of comments on this one. A lot more than I hadn't realized. Yeah, hey, so if it's Raleighites, how did Atlantic Beach lose to Outer Banks in the first round? Because even the Raleighites know that Atlantic Beach sucks. yeah, funny folks are. Yeah, Jim Trotman, who lives up there now, used to live out here. He said, yeah, folks are funny here in the Piedmont. Yeah, he's right. Of course, there are several references to the Chapel Hill Ferry. Jody O'Donnell, I think the Emerald Isle tourism motto is come visit the wannabe Outer Banks, because you'll see them. They say they try to call themselves the Southern Outer Banks. There's no such thing. Let's see. Oh, yeah, Owen Hassel, who's now editor of the Wilmington Star News, grew up in Elizabeth City. He said, I just had to pay Wrightsville Beach $15 for parking simply by looking at this bracket. Yep. Here's the thing. We win just because free parking.
Right.
You don't have to pay to park here on any of our beaches. Oh, well, take that back. You have to pay if you're not a local Kerala now. To park on the beach in Kerala. To drive on the beach is free. But if you want to drive on the beach on Hatteras or Ocracoke, you do have to pay. Yeah, that's true. But, yeah, he's right. You got to pay $15 in Wrightsville just by looking at the bracket. Yes. So, anyway. I had some issues with it. What did I say? Yeah. Okay, Raleighites, whatever. You don't know what you're missing. That was my comment about, you know, the fact that we had one beach make the Final Four after I ripped Axios for putting places next to each other in the first round and knock each other out. Totally unfair.
So being a girl from Ohio, yeah. I had never been to a North Carolina beach until I went to Campbell.
Right.
And the first Labor Day weekend, Rhonda had said, hey, my parents have a place in Topsail. You want to go? So we went. So that Topsail was my first
experience with an Outer Banks beach.
Yes.
Home of the jorts.
And
in the tank tops.
Yeah, right. And then you and I,
tank
though,
tops and jorts. That's Topsail.
We did Wilmington a lot.
We did Wilmington a lot. It was a 2-hour drive. And this was right as 40
was finished.
So it was a 2-hour drive. But we would take 421 many times. Just a little different drive. Because if we were going, I don't know, you know me, I mean, we would drive 40 on the way down and 421 on the way back or vice versa.
Yeah, he's not just like when he talks, y'all. When he drives, he likes to meander too.
Yes, I do. Oh, look at that. Yeah, but well before cell phones too, I was a distracted driver.
So Wrightsville Beach has a lot of good fond memories just because that's where we went in college a lot.
Yeah,
like,
that's
so
true.
So,
would do the day trip. We would do the day trip. I mean, we would literally do the day trip like we do the day trips to Richmond every now and then. We would drive to Wrightsville, spend the day on the beach, go downtown Wilmington, do dinner, and then drive home.
Yep.
Or we'd get a hotel. We stayed.
Alberta Whitey's.
The motels down there. Alberta Whitey's on Market Street, which is no longer there. It's now Walgreens, where Alberta Whitey's, which have. What's
Michael Jordan got
Michael
his.
Jordan's first job was there because his mom was a housekeeper there.
Yeah.
That's right. Yeah.
It was like one of those 1960s hotels, but $50 a night we could stay.
The Rosebud Motel just right out of Schitt's Creek. Same thing. I still think we could pull that off. There's a property around here we could pull that off and turn the Rosebud Motel into.
Yeah. So, I mean, so I do like those beaches, but of course we live here now and Ocracoke. I mean, still for us to get to Ocracoke, it's what, 2 hours to get to the.
It's 90-minute ferry ride now.
And then, well, 2 hours to get to.
Two
the ferry.
Hours, plus how long you're going to wait for the ferry,
right.
And then 90-minute ferry ride, another 20-minute drive. Right. I mean, it's an all-day excursion now to go to Ocracoke.
Yeah, but we're big fans of Frisco. That's our. We like to take the camper down there and go to Frisco
Woods.
Yep, Frisco Woods.
Stay at Frisco Woods.
So you know, I can see the different beaches, the different things. So for me, it's more about what do you want out of it,
right?
You know.
Yeah, and we always talk about the Outer Banks is if you're coming to sit on the beach for a week, you come to the Outer Banks. If you want to go walk a boardwalk, yeah, I know I'm boring you.
No, I'm so, so sorry. Tired. Y'all, I promise next week I will be in I will be in it. I am so tired.
It's okay. It's all right. But yeah, if you want to go walk on a boardwalk, go north. I mean, there's plenty of places for that. If you want an amusement park, you got your choice. You can go to Carolina Beach or you can go to Atlantic Beach, whatever. It's not our vibe. But if you're coming truly to get and even though the complaints are, you know, with the bypass and the development and now all the chains are coming and things like that, which we have, I'll say it, I am glad I'm going to have a Wawa because daggone it, not having somewhere to grab a quick bite to eat on that end of the beach, as much as I love Spanky's and I'll go to Spanky's all day long, having that at 10 o'clock at night after reffing a lacrosse game at First Light and driving back here and having an option other than a 7-Eleven hot dog, it's going to be nice to have that
so
Wawa.
So you'll have a Wawa hot dog instead?
No, I'll have a sandwich or something like that. Yeah. So anyway. All right. We do need to do some business here. We need to thank our good friend Stephanie Harlow. She, of course, jumping on board as one of our great sponsors here on the Sam and M podcast. And Harlow Photography, well, you know what? It is getting booking time if you are wanting to make those magic memories last a lifetime. Unforgettable photography experience tailored to all your desires. Harlow Photography is exactly what you've been looking for. Whether it's the magic of engagements and weddings, a glow of maternity, the innocence of newborns, milestones of a first birthday, graduation, school events, military homecomings and retirements, or that oceanfront or soundside family portrait session to cap another memorable Outer Banks vacation. Harlow Photography ensures every moment will be one you can cherish forever. Stephanie Harlow is your local natural light expert that captures the beauty of the Outer Banks and northeastern North Carolina. See Stephanie's portfolio and book your sessions today. Spring and summer sessions are going to fill up fast. SHarlowPhotography.com and like Stephanie Harlow photos on Facebook. Let Harlow Photography preserve your memories in stunning natural light. All right. Hey, we made it a lot longer than I thought we would today. So do we have time to get to this? No, we really don't have time to get to this. So let's get into what's going on at SamWalkerObxnews.com. Well, we've got a lot happening there. Man, has it been a wild news week. It's one of those news weeks that you hate to have to do. You know, we're losing two members of our fishing community, two members of the Outer Banks community, and just really cool guys. I mean, Griff, what can you say? I can't put into words everything that everybody said on social about Charlie Griffin. And Chad Dunn, as well, who was his mate, who we tragically lost. I mean, and this accident happened Sunday night, Monday morning. These are the weeks that you just don't look forward to when you do this business. But got a lot of other great stuff at SamWalkerObxNews.com to check out. A lot of events going on and coming up, and that's one thing we've been getting a lot of. And thanks everybody who's been sending those to us. We love putting that stuff out there, whether it's the Polar Plunge for Special Olympics, which is coming up this Saturday. That's at Jeanette's Pier. Still time to get in on that if you're listening to us on Thursday or Friday. Just so many different things. A couple of things I want to get to, and we didn't even talk about last night. We're going to do this week's episode of the Sam
and M
on the road.
I can't say it right.
Sam and M on the road. We've come up with this name on the fly. Now we can't get it right. We went to the Meet OBX last night.
Yeah,
got a trio in Kitty Hawk. Emily, I went last month solo. Emily went this time. It's steadily growing. It's just a cool social group. Hang out for a couple hours at Trio. Enjoy some drinks. Enjoy their great food. And really get to know a lot of people. And it's really cool because it's designed more for people like me who work from home, who don't get out a lot. A lot of people who have come to the area over the last couple of years and really don't have connections. We've made some connections with people who have come to the area. There's a couple of folks that are from the area, like myself, Lifetime. And it's really just a cool little group. So check it out. The next gathering of Meet OBX is going to be on Tuesday, April the 9th. Usually it's the first Tuesday, but it's on April the 9th. So the second Tuesday in April. Toyota Tower and Amanda Lotus have put this together. And it's really a cool vibe. I mean, you'll enjoy it.
I had a great time. I met lots of different people, and you just kind of work your way around the room. Everyone's working their way around the room. Have some good food, some good drinks. And yeah. I have to say, if anyone's listening, the engineering table was my favorite.
Yeah, we had a good time.
It was a good trip.
We had to get together with it. We are going to have to get.
But we met. I probably met 10, 12 new people. You met the guy who was the coach for the gymnastics at West Point. He was West Point's gymnastics coach.
Yeah.
Still goes up and helps put on meets there. He was super nice.
Guy who came to the Outer Banks to drive the pilings for the Bassinite Bridge. Now he's doing it up at the Portsmouth International Terminal. Gets up at 4 in the morning, leaves at 4 in the morning to go to work up in Portsmouth. And is probably going to be doing the same project for the Alligator River Bridge replacement. I mean, that's how diverse this group is.
Yeah, there were a couple ladies who are retired. Yeah. Her name is not Mercedes.
Mercedes. She works at Atlantic Realty in reservations.
She was born and bred on Harris Island. She was another local that was there.
Yep.
Anyway, it was just neat.
People
have been there for 15 years. One lady recently divorced.
Right.
You know, the dating pool. We need to.
We got it. Yeah, the dating pool needs a little chlorine in it. Maybe.
She was just funny. She was funny. But So I mean, I really had a good time. I walked away just laughing and feeling good and meeting different people. And so anyway, I hope I can make it to the next one with you, because I think it was definitely is something I hadn't thought about with people being at home, and not getting out and not having that socialization. A lot of people moved here to the one family. The husband said his wife came down here during her last year and a half before retirement during COVID, in their rental house, and then he retired and,
made it their residence. There's a lot of that sort. It was cool. The folks that bought a house in Stumpy Point from
tiny
home from Indianapolis to Durham to Stumpy Point. Now they're in Collington. But so it was really cool. So it's Meet OBX, usually the first Tuesday of the month, but second Tuesday coming up in April the 9th at Trio. And you can check out our socials for more details. And that will be this week. Sam
and M
on the road. Will that be dropping this weekend? Theater of Dare, they've got The Drowsy Chaperone, their farcical 1920s comedy in a musical. That is opening this weekend. Shows Friday and Saturday at 7:30. Sunday matinees at 2 o'clock this weekend and next weekend. So the 8th, 9th, 10th, and the 15th, 16th, 17th. At Theater of Dare in Kitty Hawk, milepost 4, theater with the old English spelling R-E, of Dare, OBX.com. And also on stage, Disney's The Little Mermaid, the Coast Players production at College of the Albemarle. That's coming up March 20th through the 24th. They got daytime shows for the school kids, evening performances at 7 o'clock on Friday the 22nd, Saturday the 23rd, and a matinee at 2 p.m. on Sunday, March 24th. Got a link to the info. Just search Little Mermaid at SamWalkerObxNews.com. I guarantee you that will be what comes up. It won't be me in an aerial tutu yet. But search that at SamWalkerObxNews.com. And, what you got?
On Saturday at the middle school, Curry Tech Middle School, it's the Arts Festival.
Yes, the Arts Festival.
And I think it's 10 to 2.
Okay.
I'm trying over here frantically find it, but I couldn't find it. And then just to put a bug out, the Curry Tuck FFA, they just put up today, April 12th from 1:30 to 6, and April 13th from 8 to 4 will be the spring plant sale.
Oh, yes, the spring plant sale.
That's always, in Curry Tuck, that's a big thing. And
that's a big
deal.
The
stuff sells quick. And it's very reasonable.
Very reasonable. And it supports the FFA program, the agricultural education programs at Curry Tuck High School and Middle School. I got this one, and then we'll get to that one. Southern Shores Historic Flat Top Cottage Tour. Owner Network has their list of cottages out for this year's tour. That's going to be on Saturday, April 27th from 1 to 5. Got details for you at SamWalkerObxNews.com. And something near and dear to our hearts.
Yes, I don't know if any FUMA alumni listen to us. Fork Union Military Academy. They know who they are if I say FUMA. Alumni event. Saturday, March 16th, so that's next Saturday, from 2 to 5 at the 1006 Bistro in Killdevil Hills. You can contact John Schumann at schumannj@fuma.org or call at 424-842-4368. It's the 1006 Bistro at 1006 South Virginia Trail in Killdevil Hills. And it is...
You left out something in the address. Virginia Trail? Where is that?
Virginia Dare Trail.
So, yes. Yeah. It's 1006. That is milepost 6.
And I think the advancement office is putting it up. They're inviting all alumni. But I think if someone was interested in sending their child to FUMA, it might be worth contacting them and seeing if, because it's the advancement office is doing it.
Yeah.
So I wonder if they might have some information.
Yeah, they have a lot of recruiting events. So, yep.
Anyway.
So something near and dear to our hearts. And we got a lot of more FUMA alumni around here than you realize. It is mm-hmm. kind of funny how many we run into on a regular basis. All right. Is that enough?
That's enough.
You're tired. You're done.
I love you all very much. And I really do appreciate, I had a couple through the last 2 weeks, I've had some patients say, hey, I listened to your podcast.
Yeah.
Or, you know, so I do love y'all. I'm sorry I was lackluster today, but I promise you next week I'll be rested and ready to go.
We'll try to do this in a decent hour is what we'll try to do. So, yeah. After having a good night's sleep.
I hope everyone has a really good week, though.
All right. Yeah. Thank y'all very much for all the support, all the great comments, all the compliments, all the, hey, what are you doing? And I explained it to them. Oh, my gosh, that is so cool. I want to sign up. Had that today. So neat. We really appreciate it because it does mean a lot. We keep saying that. It does mean more than you can imagine to hear those things and to see you folks when they sign up. Remember, 7-day free trial as a founder at samwalkerobxnews.com continues. Hurry, because that may go away very soon because we're getting so much demand. The 7-day trial.
And also, yes. Sponsors, figured out how to do some sponsors.
Yeah.
So you've actually added more sponsors onto.
We have figured out a way to do sponsors on the site. And that's where Scott DeMassey, thank you so much at CMITOBX.com, mm-hmm. Jumped on board. We've got a couple others who already expressed interest and are going to be coming on board soon. If you'd like to be a part of what we're doing at SamWalkerOBXNews.com, then hit me up on the socials. Hit me up on the email, SamWalkerOBXNews@gmail.com. Or, you know, just grab me by the neck the next time you see me walking by and say, hey, I want to sponsor it. Give me a proposal. Take my money. I mean, okay, I'll do it. Yeah, thanks. All right, let's get the heck out of here. We have been going on too long. It is the Sam and M podcast. It's brought to you by StatelinePowerWash.com and Parker and Smith Hammer, serving the Outer Banks and Northeastern North Carolina with over 140 five-star reviews on Google. Schedule now for that early spring discounts. Get their March Madness discount, that free gutter washing. It's available right now at StatelinePowerWash.com. Miles Carpet Cleaning, family-owned and operated, offering top-of-the-line carpet and upholstery cleaning services in Currituck and on the Outer Banks with their $99 special. Forget the rest. Call the best right now, 252-207-6707, and like them on Facebook. And Harlow Photography, your local natural light expert, capturing the beauty of the Outer Banks, online at sharlowphotography.com and on Facebook. Search Stephanie Harlow Photos. Like, follow, subscribe, hit the bell, share, and more share. Favorite podcast app, that's where you find us. Thanks for watching us on YouTube. Thanks for looking at us on Facebook. Check out the description below, and you can donate to Kelsey's Hope Foundation. Two more folks give $250. I will run a 5K in the 2-2 and the 10-mile in the 2-2. Already doing it, Donna Walton. Thank you so much for that $250 donation.
Thank you, Donna.
I'm doing the 10K in a 2-2. I know you all really want to see that. 5 stars. Make sure you do that. Interact with us. Give us all your thoughts. We'll see you next time on the Sam
and M
podcast. Buh-bye.
Bye.